Hello everyone, I'm going to demonstrate the new microscope. This is from the SOPTOP 71 Pro Max. I will explain the number on later. So let's look at this motherboard. As you can see, there's a ball in between. I'm going to zoom in by using this knob. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, as you can see, both of my hand, I didn't touch the focus. Usually we need to adjust the focus when we zoom in or zoom out. So now return. Okay, so I can say this microscope is a new trend in the market. Now we are looking at my old microscope. After I've zoomed in just a little, the focus already off. If I continue to zoom in, it is all blur until I need to readjust the focus knob. And then it will be clear again. Hello everyone, I'm Lim. If you are a new audience, you might not know, I have been using the SOPTOP microscope since the day one in the YouTube. I think it's about 9 or 10 years, but it was my second microscope. Now the one I'm using is this one. The first microscope, I forgot what brand it is, but it was terrible. When I zoom all the way down, the brightness seems not enough. The surrounding is really dark. I have changed many microscope lamps that are the same. Then I asked my seller, hey, do you have a better one? I still remember what he told me. He say, if you cannot afford Leica, Nikon, or even Olympus, because Olympus back then, it is still cheap as today, then you should get the SOPTOP microscope. And then I trusted him. I just bought it without a question. The first time I look at it, it amazed me for so long. Because not only when I zoom all the way down, I still can see everything clear, the brightness there enough. Actually, I can turn down the brightness. Let's say if you have a cheap microscope, the brightness of the lamp, you set it to 100%. With a SOPTOP, you just need to set 50%, half of it, it will be enough. So a good microscope, not only it has a clear image, it also absorbs a lot of lighting, especially after you zoom in. That microscope SOPTOP, it has followed me until today. Of course, I have tried the other brands, many. The quality is lower than this one. Of course, I cannot mention those other microscope name, but don't worry, most of them, they are from China. If you see in the US, UK, maybe there's a brand that not selling in the China, there might be a OEM from the SOPTOP. The first time I heard of the SOPTOP, I did a little investigate. It is just a small division under Sunny Optical. Sunny Optical is a giant corporate, a listed company in a Hong Kong stock exchange. Not only they supply OEM, they actually produce camera lens for mobile phones, you know, Apple, Xiaomi, Huawei, CCTV, telescope, anything that related to the glass precision elements, they are the one who make it. So this is why they don't give a F in our mobile phone repair market until recently. Finally, they have hired more staff into this department to do the marketing. Developed or invented a new type of microscope at a cheap price, of course. You cannot expensive like Olympus, that kind of branded microscope. They are totally different level, especially in the wallet damage. You will be broke even before you begin the business. Anyway, speaking of which, when we talk about the code name, I can't believe this kind of big company, they are sucks on naming. Why use this kind of name? Pro Max. It is just a shitty name from Apple. You know, even Steve Jobs, I believe, if he's still alive, he will hate it. You know, why is still iPhone 17 Pro Max? Okay, why is still counting the iPhone? It means they have failed to design a replacement of the phone. Okay, a new model, completely new fashion. This is why I'm so disappointed on every iPhone release. So back to the topic about the naming issue, okay, 71 Pro Max, it doesn't mean it can zoom to 71 times, it is still 45 times. So you need to be aware all those code name, let's say 60, 58, it doesn't mean it can zoom to 60. Okay, be careful about the code name. It doesn't matter what brand it is. Okay, you should read the spec, okay, see how much it can zoom. Because when you are repairing the CPU, you're gonna do a smallest jumper. 45 times of zoom is not enough. Usually when I do this kind of stuff, I need to use the camera manually to zoom in more and then set the contrast. So then the traces will be more visible. Or you should get another type of microscope that can zoom more than this one. Of course, I have asked the SOPTOP, do they have something capable to zoom in like 58 or 60? Yeah, they do have it. But I didn't get them because so far I'm not gonna need that because my camera is enough to do the job. If you are looking for the microscope and somehow you cannot afford the SOPTOP, then you look at the price because the price can tell the quality. A good thing doesn't come cheap because I really have reviewed a lot of microscope in this year. Hey, none of them up to my expectation. Even most of them, they are capable to zoom in more, but I cannot mention the name here. So you can do the research yourself, eh? I guess that's it for the video and see you on the next one. Bye.